Well, I grew up around golf. My dad was a greenkeeper at Ganton Golf Club in Scarborough. And so I loved golf too, but I came at it from the sort of beneath, if you like, from the lower echelons. And so when I heard about Morris's story, that echoed with me, you know, because he sort of came across those same things that I did in a way. And he never stopped trying. He just went, I'm gonna keep going, even though all the odds were against him. He was too old to start to play sport professionally, really. But he never gave up, and I've always just something about that story really just inspired me, and I wanted to tell it. So we wrote the book and then the screenplay, and here it is tonight, after about 13 years. But I first heard about it when I was about 10 years old at Morris. Well, you know what? He was called the worst golfer in the world, but I mean, he certainly isn't. He certainly probably wasn't. Like, he practiced a lot, but the problem is he didn't. He had never had any tuition. He taught himself, and you can't do that in golf. But what Mark did was throw himself into it from Morris's point of view. Mark, you know, hadn't had any tuition. Mark just went for it. And Mark did lots of research, spent a lot of time in Barrow, and I think sort of fell in love with Morris the same way that I did, and Scott did, who wrote the book, and hopefully the audience tonight will.